All right, in this quick short video, we're gonna show. I'm gonna show you how to check for stray voltage in an aquarium. We had a friend who all their fish died just fine one day. Next day they were all dead. Saltwater fish. You know, check the water parameters. They were fine. Couldn't find anything wrong. And we come down to the conclusion that could be stray voltage. So this is how you're gonna test it. You need two things. Number one, you're gonna need a multimeter. This is a Fluke. They're a great brand, but this is gonna be more expensive than most people have because it has an auto setting. This is great. You just plug it in and it goes because it knows AC, DC, and you don't need to set the voltage. If you don't have that, you're gonna look for something with a V and look for AC. But if you have a DC pump, I have a DC pump. You might want to check AC and DC. One more thing you need. You don't have to have this, but how do you know your plug is truly grounded? A device like this. I'll put a link in the description below. You need a device like this. If you do find voltage, what you want to do then is start unplugging devices one at a time until you get zero to figure out what is leaking the voltage. There's also a titanium grounding probe you can buy, and the link is in the description below. It's like $10. Well, let's go to the aquarium. We'll use a saltwater aquarium. This is my coral frag tank, and we're going to make sure that outlets. I know my outlets are grounded because I've tested them before, but I'm going to show you how that's done. And real quick, the black will go in the ground hole, and the red will go to the tank. Here's the tank we're going to test. It has a whole bunch of coral frags in here. Let's go to the plug. So we're going to unplug one of these devices and plug in the tester.
Oh, of course, most aquariums are going to be kind of dusty back here. Let's plug this in. And we have two lights and one off. So this is good. Let me show you. This is correct.
Two lights on these and one off, and that is correct. So we have proper ground. And if you have a saltwater tank like this, I might want to check this, the sump and the tank. So we're going to do both.
Okay, so stick your black probe right in there. And then,
every multimeter turned on, I'm on auto. I'm just going to stick this right in the water. 0.2 volts. 0.2 volts, that's not very much, but this is the sump. And the only thing turned on right now is this pump right here. Let me go turn that off. So in my sump, I'm actually getting a little tiny voltage right there, 0.06. Let's try the main tank. Got the same voltage right there. As I unplug the return pump from the sump, I get this here. So we got a little bit of voltage in here. Does it matter? Post it in the comments below. Are you worried about since 0.05 of a volt in the tank? Coral seems to be doing okay. Let's go check another tank. So I just tested this tank. It's a little 30-gallon. It's a little 30-gallon saltwater tank I have here. Some of the coral in there, and it had the same 0.1 voltage. So anything to worry about? I don't think so. Look how good the corals are doing in here. So wow, I was expecting zero voltage. So I just looked it up on Reef to Reef. That's the place to go. And then and read that anything below 20 to 30 volts is okay. What? That sounds like a lot. So my 0.1 volts is okay, but that's how you test it. Comment below. I don't want to reach my hand in a 20 volt tank. I don't know about that. I don't know about that. Sounds like I could get shocked. Sounds like that's not healthy for the fish. Comment below if you, how many volts is too much. That's just what I read on Reef to Reef, and I trust those guys. And comment below. Let me know if you have any, comment below if I missed anything. And any suggestions you have. Hey, thanks for watching. Click over to the side for another, I'll put another video over here for you, another aquarium video for you over there. And thank you for watching.